Steady, are you ready?
Are you ready?
What's going on?
What's going on?
Cold, fresh air. Feel the melody that's in the air. I'm down, take a look around. What's going down?
However do you want me?
However
do you need me? However do you want me? However do you need me?
However
do you want me?
Do you want me?
However do you need me?
Do you need me?
However do you want me? However do you need me?
Steady, are you ready?
Are you ready?
What's going on? Steady, are you ready?
Are you ready?
What's going on?
Tell me what's going on.
Cold, fresh air. Feel the melody that's in the air. Oh, yeah. I'm down, take a look around. What is going on?
I'm a center, and the school I currently attend is University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff.
My name is Kyle Jackson. I go to Penn Station Angle.
My name is Chris Drake. I came from John Hay High School, graduated 2021.
Hi, my name is Coach Bolden, assistant coach at John Hay for the girls basketball team. I've been in the district 28 years. I've actually coached boys for 20 years. My relationship with Coach Kreider, and even the reason I'm back, because I actually thought I was retired from coaching boys basketball all together. She watched me when I was at FBR, always probed me, asked me things, and she actually came up with the notion that if she was to ever get a head coaching job, she wanted me to come and start to coach with her. That happened 3 years ago, 4 years ago. She got the job at John Hay. She asked me to come aboard. I came aboard. She asked me to hunker down on the defensive end while she handled the offensive end. And right now, it's been a smooth transition. We're trying to change the culture at John Hay to be a more formidable team outside of the center. We understand that we're going to run that. As of right now, we're going to run that. If you're talking girls basketball, you're talking John Hay, NCMSB. We want to push that culture so everyone feels John Hay. And I think we're on the right path again.
Kreider is the most determined and selfless person in John Hay, just because I know how John Hay worked, and I know from my side of it, and just from seeing it as a student. And then my mom was the principal last year, so just seeing behind the scenes how much she do, how much work she put in to get girls scholarships.
I tell her she's a hard worker. She gonna get on you. She gonna make sure, like, she want the best for you, for sure. Like, I was on the men's team, but she for sure looked out for me, made sure I was good. Whenever she had the gym open, she'd let me come in and work out. she want the best for whoever. Like, if you, cause she not gonna hold your hand through it. She gonna tell you the real. She gonna keep it real to you. She gonna work with you.
Well, what set out John Hay from other CMSB schools is really cracker to me because, like, she goes so hard outside of basketball for all her players. Like, I probably spend more time with her off the court than on the court. Like, say we would go to, like, Dave's every day, like, just so we could eat. Like, we would spend the night over at Crater House. I remember we would all catch the bus. This was before everybody had cars. We was mad young. Like, we would all catch the bus to go to FDR every day. And we was happy to do that because Crater, like, it really just take one coach to believe in you. So I feel like what separates John Haight is the stuff that Crater does for her kids outside of school, outside of basketball. Say, like, without Crater, I really wouldn't even be playing Division I basketball right now because I definitely would have quit if she wasn't coaching at John Haight.
Playing them, bro. This is all we always play them.
No,
I didn't even bring up us.
No, I'm just saying though.
I was just talking about shooting.
No, I'm just saying though, in general.
It's just you, bro. It's just you. Every time somebody got beef, they come to you. On the hoopin' side, tiny beef. Where they come to?
I don't like give me some advice. This is why my hair look like this. Because I do this when I was just a kid. This is why I had to tell you my hair. You get this on film?
Yes.
This is why. But that's your calling. You working in your gift. This your calling. This what you supposed to be doing. You make it look easy when you walking in and doing what you're supposed to do. That's why I look easy to other people. Because you doing what you're supposed to be doing. That's what I believe. So you where you supposed to be at. You just beginning. This is what I'm about to hang around this girl. Because she going places. I just want to love for a piece of it. Just let me get
be hey, with I'm you. With
you for a little part of it.
This is about to be my manager at this point. Like this.
This is how I'm about to learn how to... This is the record I'm going to set. She's about to take me to the next level. So when you see somebody 50 learn to dunk and stuff and dribble, this is when you know this awesomeness right here. So when you see those skill sets come out of me just during this time, you're going to know. That's how you can tell greatness. When you can take something who has nothing, no skills, and put them on the court and see how I'm about to progress. You're about to see it for yourself. It is.
You can just definitely speak life into these kids. And they were so excited to have your support this year. Like, they look forward to seeing you at the games. Like, are you coming to the games? I put you on the list. Like, I wanted you there. I'd be looking forward to you just smiling, uplifting. You get angry with us. You share tears with us. You motivate us from the side. And we need that. Like, schools need that, especially female sports.
John Hay. Three grade schools in one. So my son was here, early college. Great choice, great pick. It's just a place where you can get academics and athletics all in one spot for free. It's an awesome public school opportunity. So you have early college where you can get access to college courses while taking your high school requirements, participate in awesome athletic teams, meet great people, have great experiences, internships, you have the opportunity to make connections. Also, we're bridging the gap with kids doing entrepreneurial things, so we're having pop-up shops, kids creating their own businesses, just getting them ready for this century to be able to do what they want to do, excel where they want to excel, utilize the talents while they're in school. Great opportunity, great choice. I mean, we have the coach of the year for the girls basketball team. I mean, say less. We could cut it right there. So yeah, this is a place, great opportunity. You can definitely trust the staff to have your child's best interest at heart. I can say a lot of great things. It's just something you need to see and experience. Something you definitely need to take a chance and invest your child into. And we do need to talk about the myth of Cleveland and how people see Cleveland students and feel about Cleveland. Because this school encompasses people from all over. They're not just Cleveland. They're from everywhere. So this is just And this is the Mecca right here at John Hay. Three scoops in one. Take your pick. Cut. No.
talk about the diversity in the student body, because that's something I see and I hear a lot about too.
So we have students coming from some of everywhere. We have students who are here from different parts of Asia. We have students who are here from different parts of Africa, as well as staff. So a lot of diversity, a lot of different cultures, a lot of good mesh. And like I said, students who come from area suburbs, as well as the inner city of Cleveland, from a diverse group of economical backgrounds, from wealthy to parents who may be in that poverty level. It's just a diverse group in a lot of different ways, culture, economic, as well as exposure. So it's definitely a I would say a melting pot for sure.
As I looked at Northeastern Ohio, women's basketball had a lack of attention and respect, and that just didn't sit right with me. Well, at least with my girls. I realized you had to be a certain program in order to get anything, so I made sure we put them on our schedule. I reached out to BOFA, and he had a vision, a dope vision, and I was all in. So I asked him to meet me for the first scrimmage versus Lutheran East. Lutheran East speed kicked our ass. But they fast and physical.
When you say you check the level, I'm running to each other. Call it. Y'all gotta talk to each other. Like, call it out.
At the basket, all they gonna look, pass it out to the corner. I mean, mindful. So whoever guard on top, once they make that pass, just drop. I promise you, go right here.
Game kept going, we found more of a rhythm. We start trusting each other and trusting the process. They start turning up a little bit. It was a close game. In the game, we made a few turnovers and it cost us the game. We ended up losing by three. But I knew we had the pieces. And that just showed me even more to trust the process that I'm trying to make them believe in, the coaching staff believe in, and myself. It was locked in at that point.
I'm head coach Vanetta Kreider at John Hay High School in Cleveland, Ohio. Why not Hay? Why not Hay? What other school can you go to that can give you everything that you need? Academics to athletics. We're opening doors for our kids. It's these doors that usually close to kids like ours. We're beyond diverse, and we're disciplined. I believe in every kid that comes through this building, not just on the basketball court, but in the classroom. We are a family, from our principals to our coaching staff. We are all invested in our kids. It's deeper than just basketball. We do things outside of basketball. We are a family. You never know what somebody goes through. So sometimes basketball has to be fun. You got to give an opportunity to learn and make mistakes and pick their head up throughout the way. Push them and motivate them. I'm dedicating my life right now into making these young ladies better. Because I needed that when I was younger.
Pick it up, throw it back at me, and I'm gonna roll it the other way. So you shuffle, try not to cross your feet.
I'm really excited about Jordan. He got some solid feet up. He got a little shift in his little dance move. And I can't wait to just jam with her. He's gonna be a follower. A big time follower. It's exciting. She don't even know it yet. That's the crazy part about it. She just playing basketball and she likes it. Because the ball on at this point. Honestly, they got the ball yet. She don't put the ball on one day. You can't be a nice guy. You can't be a nice guy when you play basketball. That's a weakness. And they're going to show that because every time. And as soon as she understands that, she can't play. She just can't play.
As far as what basketball has to offer, in the next 4 to 5 years, with the same coach at its reign, there's no reason we shouldn't be top 5 overall. We do have to continue to get the talent here. I do understand that Kreider trains the kids. We train our kids to be better basketball players. Just not bring your talent and we feast off the talent. You're going to learn basketball here. Also, the exposure. We have a cameraman, BOFA Productions, who has been following us since last year. Our kids have gotten a lot of exposure from it. And I really, truly believe that's also one of the reasons that some of our kids are getting other college offers, because it's not just your basic send me some tape. We have highlights, it's screen, you're not only looking at the basketball end of it, you're seeing their life on camera, and I think that helps out with it. So the best place to be right now in CMSD as far as girls basketball is John Hay.
Coming to John Hay, you're actually going to have to want to play. I know a lot of high school basketball is just people like wanting to play basketball and going with the flow, but Kreider's trying to give people scholarships to go to college. So if you want to come here, you're going to have to put all that laziness aside, all of that I don't want to do work stuff aside, and really dedicate yourself to the program, because she's over dedicated. So if you're not dedicated, then she's not going to go as hard for you. You got to really trust in her and invest your time, because she's going to invest the time in you for sure.
Hey, if you really don't love basketball and you really don't want to hoop and it's not what you really want to do, like, don't even waste your time, because it's serious. Like, they take this real serious. And if you sign, or if you say you come in here, be dedicated to Kreider, because she's going to give you 110%, so at least give her 100. But I say if you give her that 100, you're going to reap all the rewards and benefits on the court, off the court, in school, out of school. She's going to ride for you for sure.
This will be the best opportunity, because, like, first of all, you're getting a coach that's not only going to push you on the court, but she's going to push you off the court also, and not even in the classroom. She's going to push you on the court, in the classroom, and just push you to be a better person. Like, she cares about more than just basketball. So, like, that's something I would tell people, like, if they were trying to come in. And then from a different standpoint, like, not even with Kreider, like, just the school in general. So, like, John Hay is a very, like, people got their jokes, okay, every school got their little flaws and all that. But John Hay was, like, a really, really good school.
I feel like I'm making an impact. That's one reason I'm staying at John Hay. I refuse to leave my city when they need me the most. I need my city. I believe John Hay will be one of the top schools in Northeastern Ohio. And it's time people understand that. We're going to put the work in, and we're going to outwork each person. We're going to outwork each program. It takes a village, and we are a village here. I appreciate my coaching staff. I appreciate my principals here and my athletic director for all the support they give me. Our parents are a major support system for our kids and myself. They believe in me enough to entrust their kids with me.
Sharks that smell blood in the water. Like you said, we need to be getting it and going and going. They're doing the exact same thing, so we should get the same thing every time. we've started taking away that middle person that's trying to shove it to that middle person, okay? So our middle person inbox needs to get in front of them or get three quarters on top, either way, all right? Take that the way we could. But we should have about 15 to 20 more points.
Right. We're not boxing out still, and it's getting my nerve. We're still trying to grab the ball with them. Why can't we put a body on somebody? To go to the next level, we have to learn how to box out. Period. That ball go up, everybody put a butt on somebody. One, two, back. Let the ball drop in the middle. That's how I know y'all did a good job. The ball just bounced, and then we can go get the ball. Y'all did a great job. Unless the ball just dropped in your hand. Your goal is to have that ball bounce in the middle. Everybody should be covered. We not locked in like that yet. These are the games we get better. We got some hard games this year, and we can't box them out. We can't out-jump everybody. Is it working now?
No.
It's not. So this is happening. Look, it's time to put somebody in there. I see somebody in the paint. And that ball go up, and we don't box out, you come now. We still playing down, y'all.
Yes.
Let's tap yes. in right now. Let's tap in right here.
It's blood in the water. It's either you going to go eat or not.
Okay. Y'all ready?
Mm-hmm.
Any questions?
No.
Go out there and put some shots up real quick.
Somebody stole my game.
Don't take your fucking steps. I don't care. Run it up. Play your game. COVID can happen tomorrow, shut everything down. Right? So don't get your all. Every game, let it go. Defensive mind frame and willing to share the ball, they're going to take us to the next level.